Hi, I'm David from YouTube. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, David.
And it's very exciting about the Navi language. as we were just talking about, there's a big online following of people who are actually learning Navi. How does that make you feel?
I'm astonished. I'm amazed. I'm gratified. I'm humbled. I mean, I never thought that in the space of really just about 3 months, the language would have exploded the way it has. Mm. But there are a lot of very dedicated people, very enthusiastic people who are really learning it remarkably well. I'm getting long emails written to me entirely in Navi.
Unil Terantok.
How's your Navi?
Alveut ario hengeja. Nau masatnok lurto siveji.
The first actual step in constructing the language was to determine the sounds and the sound system. The consonants and the vowels and the pseudo vowels and the diphthongs sounds like P, T, K, M, N, N, P, A, and P, U, and K. So once you do that, then you're ready to begin morphology and syntax. F-A-K-I-M. Being part of the Avatar experience was utterly fascinating and tremendously exciting to me. Definitely part of my job was to teach Navi to the actors. And I say things like, you know, that was really good, but remember the vowel at the end of that word is not a, it's a. Sometimes the actor was very receptive to that. Sometimes they saw me coming and ran the other way because they had other things to think about.
Navi.
Nadi.
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 Navi.
By and large, though, I think things turned out pretty well. Hearing the language that I had come up with on the screen in the final version of the film was, as you might imagine, a very special feeling. But in a sense, what's happened to Navi post-Avatar is, at least for me, maybe the most exciting thing of all. People are actually using it for genuine communication. There are a couple of instances of Navi learners in different parts of the world who don't share any other common language except Navi. So, I mean, that's something I frankly did not anticipate. And at this point, I'm working very closely with the community to develop the language for it.
Listen, Owe, Owe,
Owe. I get long emails written to me entirely in Navi to get people fired up about the wonders of language, whether it's human language, or whether it's language of the Navi, I'm just tickled.
Au mona pe sing mr pukap kina vol.
What is your name?
I'm Paul Frommer.
How old are you?
68.
What is your educational background?
Well, I have my undergraduate degree in mathematics from the University of Rochester and my master's and doctorate degrees in linguistics from the University of Southern California.
Language has a way of bringing people together. What are some Navi language social interactions you have?
Well, I've had the pleasure of attending several Navi meetups. The first was in 2010. The famous Ut'a'amenaring, the meeting in the forest at the wonderful home of Britton Watkins and Josh Feldman. And then I attended two gatherings in Seattle in 2011 and 2012. It was both in the summer. And I've also made a lot of friends in the Navi community.
You're currently in a relationship?
I am.
Do you speak Navi with your husband?
John does not speak a lot of Navi. I think he knows a couple words. Actually, we sometimes speak Persian with each other a little bit because we spent a year in Iran together.
And would you say you formed new friendships from your involvement in the Navi language?
Absolutely.
What is a good activity for people practicing the language of Navi?
good activity for people practicing Na'vi? Well, language is communication, and coming up with real communication situations where you're genuinely trying to convey information, as opposed to making it a game, is what helps you develop in the language the most. So people writing to each other in Na'vi, people hopefully speaking a little bit to each other in Na'vi via Skype or face-to-face, those kinds of things really help.
Many people in the fan community, especially students of the Na'vi language, have Na'vi identities.
Uh-huh.
Do you have one?
Well, I go by Paul, spelled P-A-W-L, which is the Na'viized version of my name. I'm also known in the community as Kariu Paul, which means Teacher Paul. That was an appellation that was kind of given to me by the community.
Can you say that you're a fan of Avatar?
Well, I have to tell you, my my take on the movie is totally subjective. I mean, I have a difficult time being objective about that movie, having been involved in its creation. I think it's an extraordinary film.
What are your language-related hobbies?
Hobbies? Well, I've always been interested in languages from an early age. I mean, my very first exposure to a language that wasn't English was probably Yiddish, because my parents, although they were primarily English speakers, were also speakers of Yiddish, and mainly spoke it between the two of them when they didn't want me and my brother to understand. But then when I was young, maybe, I think probably 6 or 7, I was sent off to Hebrew school, because that's what you experience when you were a young Jewish kid growing up in New York. And so the first foreign language that I actually studied was Hebrew, and found that very interesting. I really loved it. When I was in junior high school, I was fortunate enough to be put in a Latin class. So I wound up having 4 years of Latin, which was great. I had some French in high school. Then in college, I continued French and began German. Afterwards, I had a major language experience, because when I graduated college in 1965, I joined the U.S. Peace Corps as a volunteer, and I was sent to Malaysia, where I learned the Malay language. We had 3 months of training in Hawaii, but then were shipped off to Malaysia, and I wound up actually teaching mathematics in the Malay language, which was quite a challenge at first, but something I really enjoyed. So I've always kind of been fascinated with language. I tried to study some Arabic on my own. In the middle 70s, John and I lived in Iran for a year, where I was teaching, and John was part of an advertising agency. And I plunged into the study of Persian, and actually wound up doing my doctoral dissertation on an aspect of Persian grammar. So language has always been part of my life. I mean, certainly as a student of linguistics, but also just the joy of just messing around with different ways of communicating, just rolling around words in your mouth, and just experiencing the joy of human language. That's always been part of my life.
What are your favorite languages to experiment with?
Well, favorite languages. I guess they're the ones that I've actually lived in and used. So my two big foreign language experiences were Malay in Malaysia and Persian in Iran. So those are definitely two of my favorites. I probably have made the most progress in those two languages, after, you know, being able to live it, to live each one on a day-to-day basis. gee, in terms of another language, I mean, I've never found a language I didn't like. I think probably every linguist will say that. Every language has its own uniqueness, its own charm, its own challenge. So certainly I've enjoyed trying to figure out some things about Arabic. I like Latin. Oh, and I had a year of Mandarin Chinese, which was a very different experience, but something that was very important to my development.
What are you looking forward to in the way of language development in the Avatar franchise?
Well, of course, Avatar 2 and 3 have been announced, and there's some indication that we will actually get going on those two sequels this year, in 2013. So I'm happy to say that I will be involved in the sequels. Exactly how is not clear. Exactly what Jim Cameron has in the back of his mind in the way of the development of the language, whether it will simply be a continuation of the Na'vi that existed in the original movie, whether there will be dialects, that's not entirely determined yet, at least not as far as I know. But one way or the other, I'm very much looking forward to continuing to work on Na'vi in the sequels.
What is your take on constructed languages and the role they play on education?
If you're talking about language education, I think they can play an interesting role. One thing that's been very gratifying to me is that a number of young people who have told me that they never really got involved in their Spanish classes and didn't particularly like trying to learn French, nevertheless have developed this fascination for Na'vi, and they really want to know how it works. And they're asking me questions like, you know, what's the difference between a transitive and an intransitive verb? For me, this has considerable implication for education because it excites the imagination. And if people are excited by this language, for whatever reason, and if they really plunge into the study of it, they will learn linguistic concepts, which I have no doubt will transfer over into the learning of real languages. So if Na'vi can be a transition for some people between no particular interest in learning languages to a fascination with language, I think that has tremendous implications.
Do you speak Na'vi with John?
John and I don't speak a lot of Na'vi together. I think John knows a couple words. Actually, we do speak some Persian together because we lived in Iran for a year in the mid-70s. And every so often we'll speak Persian with each other, which seems very natural. We say, Allah Abya, which means, sir, come here.
What was it like for you seeing the actors speaking the language on screen after you had worked on the language?
Well, seeing the actors speak the language on screen was a big thrill. And mostly they did an excellent job, and I was very pleased with the dedication. And the final product, I think, was pretty good. In terms of how Na'vi affects my relationship, John sometimes refers to himself as a Na'vi widow or widower, whichever you like. There are times when I get involved with a grammatical discussion with someone else and he kind of feels a little bit left out, but that's okay. I mean, that's to be expected.